watch them live, we watch them die. Now who can tell how this will be? Now what is left here to believe? Never felt like this before. I feel no guilt for wanting more. I'll take my chances here with you. Tell you feel it too, so let's not hide it. I won't hide it anymore. Who knows what life is for? Who
I think I started to do the record by opposition at the records I've done before. You know, I had done four classical albums. The idea was very simple. It was to like mark a date on the calendar, like the first day of spring. And from that day on, through the whole year, I would write music as a diary. And at the end of the first 6 months, I already had an album. So that's when I realized that I had to continue doing it, and it probably would be two albums. That's when everything started, you know, to understand. I started to understand what the idea was all about. Released the record as it was done. So we released like the first record released at the first day of spring, and the second one we did on the first day of the fall. What connects the songs one to another is really the time, like a timeline, like in Facebook, you know, like in the social media where you follow a timeline and you just see how things went, or and that was exactly what I wanted to do, but with songs, basically. I am also an absolute control freak. I really am. Only two choices of doing things, right? If you can do it yourself, or you can just ask someone to do it for you. And I'm always very uncomfortable with that idea. When I do it myself, I'm the only one to blame. You know, I don't have anybody else to blame. So I think it's the best way of doing it. like slowly I'm trying to release that, because it's really hard, you know, to keep up with so many things in this business, to do the videos, to do the songs, to play them, to do the artwork, to do the photography. I've done like 9 videos, very risky videos, very strange ones too. But the thing is, it's always a challenge, you know, and my crew is a very small crew. It's always the same crew, always the same makeup artist, the same guy doing the photography, the same guy doing the camera. It's always me editing, always. Most of the time, it's not really that expensive videos. It's just videos that just try to work with good ideas. I spent like 10 years taking pictures with that Polaroid camera, and I have thousands of Polaroids. So at some point I was organizing them and I was looking at them and I thought, you know, this would become an amazing book, because this is like my whole life and the beginning of discovering music and being in this music business. And I decided, you know, to get it all together in a book, almost like a diary, but a very, you know, abstract one. And I think Nunu and Sonia and everyone from The Gift and John and Miguel would agree, you know, we're friends for many years. I've known them, you know, even before we started both our projects. When we were like little, before we had any record out, we already knew each other, because we live not in the same town, but in very close towns. And we have a very similar history. I was for many years a big fan of the Cardigans, and they're Swedish. You know, I had all the albums of the Cardigans, and I knew, well, many of my friends knew all the songs from them. So the thing is, you can actually have such a small country as Portugal that admires a band and has a fan club of a band that's in Sweden, a band from Belgium called Deus, which is a big, big band. Yeah, and it has a great group of followers in Portugal. For example, Tindersticks are one of the bands that probably the biggest place they play is Portugal, you know, and I think that is because when we love something and we don't care where it comes from, we just connect with it and we just go for it, because there are so many fans of the Seattle movement in Portugal. There always was, especially in the 90s. I lived that too. I saw Nirvana in Portugal, and back then, like, I think 80% of the kids just was into the Seattle thing, and some of them kept it. The thing that surprised me the most is the 20-somethings now. The guys like 23 years old still love Pearl Jam, and I've been away from that like years ago. Jeff Buckley dying is one of the greatest losses in the music business that ever happened. I remember Grace was. I discovered the album in a very odd way, because. Back then, when the album was released, I had a friend of mine said to me, you know, I bought this record, and because I read an American magazine that this guy's really good, and I bought it to give to someone, like a present, but I'm going to record it in a tape for you. And that's what he did. He recorded the tape, and he gave it to me. The tape, I haven't listened to it, and the tape stood in my house, you know, for about 6 months. Without listening to it. It was just right there. And one day I was studying cinema, and I looked at it and I thought, what is this name? And I didn't even remember that. And I put the tape on, and that tape stood there for the next 6 months. It never came out. My shows, it's not only about, you know, standing on the stage and playing songs. I want people to get out of there like something really, really happened, you know, and shock them. Not shock them, but impress them in some way. And these shows here in Spain, I think, will be amazing. Like I told you, this comes from a tour we did last year in Portugal. And we're doing it again here, and we're really excited to go back to that tour and to the way we built it, because it's very different, like I said. There's a lot of surprises, a lot of, you know, of corners and things that you're not expecting in a concert. So I just hope that people enjoy it. That's it.